Have you been video conferencing on your Mac recently and you do some totally innocent hand gesture like two fingers up and all of a sudden you're greeted with balloons? Or maybe you did two thumbs up and you got fireworks? And you thought to yourself, why did that happen? And more importantly, how do I make it never, ever, ever happen again? My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and you are in the right place because in today's video, I'll teach you how to turn off that function. But more importantly, I'd like to teach you how to properly use the new reactions functionality that's a part of macOS 14 Sonoma and iOS 17. Apple makes amazing software. And every year they update it with tons of new features and functions, but they never bother to tell us lowly users what those features or functions are and how to exactly use them. So you can imagine my frustration and embarrassment when I was on a video conferencing call with a very important business client, and I said, listen, there's two important critical things we gotta talk about. And I got balloons. It was embarrassing. It was unprofessional. So you may be saying right about now, great, Dylan, teach me how to turn it off. I never ever want to have it, and I will teach you that. But before I do, I want to show you what the reactions functionality is actually capable of doing. You see, Apple created a global video filter that allows you to use these reactions and other functionality in Zoom, in Google Meet, in Teams, in FaceTime, and all sorts of other video apps. So let's hop over to the computer and take a look at how we take better control over it. As you'll see in the upper right-hand corner of your menu bar, there's a new icon there. It's a green video camera. And you may be thinking to yourself, I don't remember ever seeing that there. That's because it's part of this operating system update. When you click on it up here, you'll notice some options that we see down at the bottom here. There's three separate settings. One is portrait, one is studio light, and one is reactions. And then underneath that, we've got this thing called mic mode. So let's go through each of these one at a time. If you've ever taken pictures with an iPhone and you've taken the nice portrait shots that blur the background, you recognize that portrait concept. If I turn this on here, I want you to notice that it blurs out my background. And by clicking the little arrow to the right here, I can actually control how blurry or clear it is behind me, which is better than what you can do when you turn the blur function on Zoom or on Google Meet or any of those other video things. You just don't have the fine-tooth control that you have here. In addition to that, underneath that, we've got something called Studio Light. And again, if you've taken pictures with an iPhone and you've taken portrait shots, you know that the Studio Light is a software that allows you to enhance the lighting on a person's face as if they were in the studio. Kind of a nice thing to be able to do when you're on a video conference call. So I'm gonna go ahead and click Studio Light on. You're gonna notice it darkens the area around me and really highlights my face. There's a little arrow to the right over here that I can turn up or down depending on how high lit I want my face to be. And down below that, we'll see the reactions button. Now you can easily click on the little green bubble here to turn reactions off or on for any app. And you'll notice that different apps show up across the top here. So you can have it turned on for FaceTime, but off for Zoom if you like. And you can easily globally turn it on or off right there. If you click on the arrow to the right side though, you're gonna see what those reactions controls are. And there are eight separate reactions. We're gonna start with the top left and go across the top bar. The first one you'll see is the heart hands, making a heart out of your hands, and you will have hearts come pouring right out. To the right of that, we've got the like reaction. Put your thumb up like this, and you'll get a like bubble. And directly to the right of that, we've got the don't like reaction, which is very similar. It's just a thumb straight down, like this. And it gives you that don't like bubble. To the right of that, we've got balloons, which are done with two fingers, just like this. Now let's drop down to the second row. Starting on the left, we've got the rain clouds. The rain clouds are two don't like thumbs down at the same time, just like that. Rain's all over your parade, right? To the right of that, we've got confetti. That's two victory signs like this. Kind of a cool one, kind of like the confetti one. To the right of that, we've got fireworks. Fireworks are two thumbs up, just like this. Very exciting, dramatic. And the last one is lasers. And the lasers is done by giving yourself the rock and roll hands like this, and suddenly we get lasers. So now that you've seen each of those reactions functions, you can either use them or turn them off for any apps that you don't want to have accidentally popping up in front of you. Below that, we've got this thing called mic mode that I just want to talk about for a moment. In the same way that Apple gave us global video filters, they also gave us global audio filters. And what this can allow you to do is have your microphone, a standard microphone, which is how most of us use our microphones in general on video conference calls, etc. Or you can call voice isolation, which drops out any background noise and makes sure that your voice comes through crystal clear. All of those functions are really awesome and amazing, and I love that Apple built them into macOS Sonoma, but the really cool part is that they also put them on the phone. And in just a moment, I'm gonna teach you how to master all of those reactions functions from the phone as well. But before I do, if I already solved your problem, or answered a question, taught you something you didn't already know, I'd love you to give me a thumbs up on this video. It just makes it so much easier for other people to find this video and get this help. And if you've got a question or a comment, drop it down below. I love to hear from you guys. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, this is a great time to do that. Just hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so that you're always alerted whenever I drop new content. And with that being said, let's step over to the phone and let's see how we control the reaction functions over there. So here I am on a Zoom call on my phone. In order to control them on the phone, we're gonna need to go into our control panel, which is accessed by pulling down from the upper right corner of your screen, just like this. If you're new to the control panel and would like more information about it, I check out that video up above where I talk all about how to use the control panel and how to customize it. But for now, let's focus on these two parts of the control panel. You're gonna notice up at the top, we've got our friendly little green video camera, and also an orange microphone to the right. Let's start by clicking on the green video camera, and from right here, you're gonna notice that I've got the portrait mode, just like I had on the computer. So I can turn that off completely, and you'll notice that the background stays really in focus, or I can turn it on, and I can adjust how my background looks. I can also turn on or off studio light. Right now it's on, let's turn it off. You see it drop out and give me better coloration in my face. I can click the three dots to the right of studio light, and I can adjust how much or how little I want that studio light effect. And right here at the bottom, there's the reactions button. So let's go ahead and turn that on. From here, inside of the Zoom conference, if I use my finger gestures, I'm gonna get those same reactions, whether it's thumbs up for fireworks or a peace symbol for balloons. And if I don't want them, all I have to do is pull down from the upper right-hand corner, come into the video effects section, and you can turn on or off portrait, if you want to have that blurred effect, or studio light, or reactions at any time that you want. And over here on the right side, you're going to see our microphone control. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and you're going to see there's three separate settings. There's standard mode, which is what most people use the majority of the time. There's voice isolation, which is great if you're in a noisy environment and you want to make sure the person hears you and not all of that background clatter and noise. And then if you're playing music or if you want to make sure a large range of what is being heard can be heard by the other person, you can turn it into wide spectrum. But what's really nice about those voice controls is they're not isolated into a video conference. If you're on a phone call and you'd like to adjust your audio, you can come right in here and make that change and go right into voice isolation right off a phone call, which is an amazing feature and an amazing functionality. So that's how you utilize and properly use the reaction functionality both on your computer and on your phone. Now you can just turn it off, or you can show everybody a little bit of love. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I'll see you next time.